And through this door is your second map lab to destroy.
Negative. A block north of your location.
Understood.
Hell yeah, a brand new weapon, the baseball bat. Bring it, bitches. He looked like a retard. Look at that with his like his flame hoodie. Like what a fucking poser.
Alright. We got riot activity outside.
Going outside onto the roof here.
Don't get the bright idea coming in here. Just stay focused on finding Van Horn.
The riot shotgun can hold more shots, and it's got a better better distance. So I usually like to take the riot shotgun.
Sounds like the situation's on its way to completely fucked out there. Cut the cattle room.
Owned. I'll take that. SMG, son. I had to show you guys that. Normally, it falls and it's supposed to scare the shit out of you, but it was a little delayed.
Stop worrying. I'm in the main lobby.
Here's your first crime scene.
Rosa, come in.
Glad to hear you're still with us. What do you got?
A dead body.
Okay, let's try and make an ID.
Adult male. He's a cop. And pick up his badge. It's police badge 46. It's a bit of blood
receiving
on it, but you can
now.
Tell it's 46.
Male police officer. Service number belongs to a Deputy Dennis Black of the Metro Police Department. I'll notify MPD. According to dispatch, he's been missing for almost 2 days now. Can you determine the cause of death?
All right. COD. Torso. Oops, gunshot.
Got it. Good work.
Simple as
that. It appears the victim bled out from a gunshot wound to the chest. I'm guessing the shooting is connected to our investigation somehow. Has the body been moved? Is this the crime scene?
Pull out your UAV and zoom in on the trail there, the blood trail.
Okay,
you can see the handprints
in
there.
The blood trail suggests the victim crawled to this location, then died. It may lead you back to the crime scene. And possibly Van Horn.
Alright, before you follow the blood track, you want to veer off to the right. Go through this door. Be careful, there's a dude in here with a Colt. And grab your next antenna.
Unemployment has grown dramatically in the city, especially in the downtown districts. We now have an unemployment rate of 16%. Where did they all go? They didn't leave the city from what we can tell. They're right here on the street living with crime, murder, and insanity. Why did they walk away from their family, good-paying jobs, or homes to sink into this quagmire of drugs, violence, and hardcore crime? You want to know. We want to know. Stay tuned to City News for further live on-the-scene reports. I'm Tony Rhodes.
The subplot is actually kind of interesting if you pay attention to those TVs and emitters.
Excuse me.
Jesus. Oh, forgot about him. Whoa.
Get the fuck.
Stick to the mission and keep searching.
Alright, there we go. I don't know why I picked that up. So you can use the UAV light if you want to follow the blood trail. And it'll, like, give you some other hidden shit, but you just follow the guide. Anyway, careful. Whoa. Fuck, come on, die. Left. Oh, knife to the face. Come on. God damn, that guy was a trooper. He would not go down. Anyway, you got your next emitter in here. Actually, I think it might be your first emitter. Oh, sure. No, it's your second. Sorry. Totally grabbing the toilet seat. That way you can say clever lines like eat shit and die or... I don't know. He got raped, man. Anyway, he'll bust through the wall, and you just gotta go in here and grab the TV.
Rampant crime has taken hold of the city, and one such hotspot is the once prestigious Preston Hotel. Here is Tony with more on the subject.
The Preston Hotel. No longer a city landmark, but a symbol of how dark this has become. Drugs and violence can be found throughout the hotel, and police are no longer making patrols in the area unless under heavy guard. It's a sad reminder of what has been lost. Listen to my special, The Condemned City, tomorrow at 6. Back to you, Sarah.